Alright guys, so today we're going to review some of the 2023 more affordable budget models that Sony has and Samsung has. So this is mostly the 2023 lineup. Any model ending with an L signifies that it's a 2023. And we're going to go with some prices. So right now for $1,200, you can pick up this is one of the top models that Sony has. Not top, well, let's go with medium. It's the X90L, so it's one below the top as opposed to the 95 model. But if you look carefully, you can now, this is a full LED Q quantum dot mini LED model, that one, and the top left is the A80L, which is an AMOLED panel. So you can compare and contrast the contrast, the black levels. As you can see, this one is significantly brighter. And this is a 65 inch, which I think is a really good deal at this price point. It's $1,200 plus tax and fees, but look at the picture quality, it's just stunning. I mean, the brightness, it may not have the black levels, but then again, it doesn't have the black crushing. And in an environment such as this at Best Buy, you see how bright it is, and they got really powerful white lights here in the shop. Now above it, it's the lower tier, the X77L, which is a 2023 model, and that's a 75 inch. So if I'm correct, and that's even more affordable. As you can see though, the picture quality is not so nice. So that's a whopping 75 inch for only $929. I believe they only recently lowered this price in the last few days, because last time we checked it was a little higher. But above it, you're going to see the X77. Now that's not full array, it's an LED TV, but it's not the quantum dot version. And to the left here, we have a whopping 85 inch model here, as you can see, but the quality is nowhere as nice as this one, the X90L, you see right in front of you. So I'm going to stand right in the middle. Unfortunately, normally they have the same content, but today they don't have the same content. But if I had to choose, honestly, I would not go for the OLED on the top left. I'd rather go for this one. It's a much better deal. They're both 65 inch, but the OLED model. So the OLED model is a whopping $800 more than the X90L. And in my humble opinion, is it worth $900 more for the same inches? No way, Jose, you take a look. So I'm gonna show it to you. I'm going to stand very still and take a look at the top left and the bottom right. So the price difference between those two is a whopping $800, and no way is that OLED looking $800 more expensive. I don't know if you'll agree. My eyes are lying to me, and your eyes would be lying to you as well. Does it have better black levels? Maybe. Not by much, I'll be honest with you. But let's go to the side viewing angles, which is extremely important too. So from the side, not bad. I mean, as you can see, because of the brightness, it seems to manage to hold its own. So from the side, the Sony still looks okay. You know, in comparison, because it's so vibrant, the colors are so vibrant and dynamic in this quantum dot panel, I think it just passes with flying colors. You know, that OLED there, even though it's in store mode, look how dim it is, the light. Yeah, you're not gonna like that, honestly. It may have better response time though when playing games, but you know, are you really gonna pay $800 because it has 20, 30 ms more, milliseconds more response time? I don't think so.